Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So in our previous lecture we discussed about singleton design pattern. What is the need of implementing the singleton design pattern from pest automation perspective, and then we implemented the singleton design pattern using the lazy initialization concept, and this is also known as classic implementation of singleton design pattern. But they are like associated challenges in the singleton design pattern using the lazy initialization, especially related to thread safety. So what do we mean by thread safety? So when we are supposed to deal with multi-threading, then this concept come into the picture, meaning two thread should not interfere with each other. This is known as thread safety. Soon I'll be uploading a video on the thread safety as well. Right, but we are going to discuss about the thread safety now from the singleton design pattern, as we are currently discussing on the singleton design pattern. Let me show you one diagram on what are the different techniques of implementing singleton design pattern. So singleton design pattern can be implemented by four ways. One is lazy initialization, which we have already covered. Then there is a eager initialization, which is a thread safe. Lazy initialization was not thread safe. I'll be just discussing on the same. Then in this lecture we are going to discuss about eager initialization and how to avoid or how to achieve, I mean, thread safety. Then we are going to discuss about synchronized, and last one is the double check. So synchronized, eager and double check, all three are thread safe, meaning the thread won't interfere in these cases. So let me jump onto the code without further ado. So in this lecture we are going to discuss, first of all let me show you like what we are going to discuss. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about what are the challenges associated with the lazy initialization, which we just mentioned, like thread safety, and how to overcome them using the eager initialization. Okay, so let me jump to the code side. So this is what was lazy initialization, right? So in lazy initialization, what we were doing, we were calling this get instance method. So first and foremost thing was, we made the constructor as private, and then after, what we did, whenever we are calling this get instance method, only then we were initializing the object of this particular class. This is why it was known as lazy initialization. So suppose like two threads are trying to call this get instance method, so both the threads may get the duplicate objects, means they can get two objects out of it. This is how we like get multiple objects, and we will lose the thread safety, right? So for example, two threads may be like running in parallel and they are trying to access get instance. So in that case, instance, they will find instance as null, and both will get the instance, right? And this way they will get the two instances of it, or two objects of it. So this is what was the thread safety concern in lazy initialization. So to overcome that, there is a concept of eager initialization. So in eager initialization, instead of just defining the reference variable as like a lazy initialization, what we are doing, we are initializing the object as well. So whenever we will call this get instance method, we will get the same instance again and again. This way we will get only the single instance. Okay, so this kind of singleton design pattern with eager initialization is used when we are supposed to use a single instance only throughout the execution, and it is for the lightweight. Okay, this is how we can achieve the thread safety, as we are getting the single thread, right? We won't be creating the two instances of it, right? So in the next lecture we will be discussing about how to achieve singleton, or how to create singleton design pattern using synchronized keyword. And later on in the upcoming session we will be discussing on singleton using the double check concept. Okay, so that is it for now on singleton implementation using the eager initialization. So we have just created the object, right? So thank you for now. If you really like this video, please support me, like, share and subscribe my video, so that we can reach to the right audience, and this way we will help each other in growing. Thank you for now.